Tyreek Hill has been cleared by the NFL to now join the Chiefs. So everything that's going on, the practices, he's cleared to play for the season. And some people are on both sides of it. Obviously, if you're a Chiefs fan, depending on how you viewed the information that came out about, you know, the alleged thing with his son, his fiance, girlfriend, whatever she was, that was recording him secretly. And, you know, recently there was new audio that suggests that it looked more like a setup with the way that it was happening. So it's kind of weird. I just don't understand exactly why they put certain information out, because now it doesn't matter what happens, he's going to be viewed a certain way. See, that's the part that's really crazy about this whole scenario, because, you know, people, once somebody sees something or hears something that resembles anything that people want you to believe, it's pretty much like this guy is pretty much done. Like, there's no, you know, video evidence of whatever he allegedly did. The NFL said that they did a thorough investigation to find out whatever they could, and they couldn't find anything. All the protective services and stuff like that went into it. I thoroughly read the article and the letter that the NFL released, and it looks as if they did their due diligence. Now, I don't know, and you don't know. Like, only he and his and the girl knows exactly what happened to the son. We don't really know what happened, but as far as what goes on with Tyreek Hill, it's very, very interesting that, you know, regardless of whatever came out, you know, like, you know, all the other later evidence that came out with the new audio, and it's showing that, you know, pretty much, like, he didn't really do anything. Like I said, it's weird, because the one that we heard first. Where he was like, you should be scared of me too, and all that kind of stuff like that. That kind of set his fate, bro. Like, you just got to be very, very careful. And it's unfortunate that people don't really understand that, you know, there's a way to deal with stuff, especially children and stuff like that. And you got to be very, very careful, you know, when dealing with children, because things like this will occur. And, you know, bro, the spotlight is on you even more. You know what I'm saying? When anything happens. Like, let's just say, like, he goes to the park and, you know, you're in the spotlight as an NFL player. So everything that you do is extremely scrutinized. So with this situation right now, I've already gotten several different types of feedback via at @GMyersWorld on Twitter. You guys can always tweet me what you feel about it. I did post the picture, and I'm listening to all your feedback. And some of you guys brought up Zeke Elliott, that he didn't do anything and he got 6 games. You know, this is what's interesting about the NFL. I don't know if Jerry Jones didn't say that nothing was going to happen to Zeke if they would have still suspended him. Because, like, sometimes, regardless of how powerful you think you are, sometimes you got to be quiet. And I think that Jerry Jones was just a little bit too outspoken. When you look at the Chiefs situation, you see how they kind of, like, downplayed it. Because didn't that other dude that kicked somebody at a thing, I forgot his name, Kareem Hunt, like, you see how fast they released him, even though he was, like, balling out and stuff like that? That's because of the video footage. You see what I'm saying? With Zeke, there was no video footage. He was doing other wild stuff. He pulled somebody's top down. But there was nothing that showed that the girl, that he did whatever the girl alleged. And the girl's friend testified that she was lying. So I can understand the rage in regards to that. But it goes synonymously with this. Like, the audio, he doesn't actually do anything other than say something crazy. Like, you're not seeing him do it. Like, if the video showed him, like, being aggressive and doing anything wild, then I think that the NFL would have had no choice but to, you know, suspend him and do whatever. But because it's audio, and then they released the later audio, that kind of shows that he's being, like, more upfront with it. Like, he really didn't do anything. I don't know exactly how, like, after I heard the second release of the audio, it seemed as if it was, like, some kind of, it was a setup. That's how I viewed it after the second thing. But again, I don't know if he actually did it. I don't know what happened. And I'm not ready to, unless I see that he actually did it, I'm not ready to just condemn anyone. You know what I'm saying? Because people make up stories every day. I gotta actually visibly see it. Now again, him getting caught in the audio saying what he said to her, that wasn't a good look. I agree with that. But again, as far as what people are saying about what he did to his son, I didn't see it. You know, I didn't see it, and I didn't hear him say or admit that he did it. So as far as I know, I don't know exactly where the NFL went with it as far as their investigation, but they cleared him, all right? Now, after we get through all of that, that's just what I wanted to share with you guys before I got into the whole thing, now that all the Chief fans are completely like, well, I don't know if all the, I don't want to say all of anything because everybody doesn't always agree, but most Chief fans are saying, yo, we're back now. So they already got over it. They're like, yo, okay, whatever. I don't know what happened. And why are they doing that? Because now, if you guys look at my previous video where all the Chief fans are raging on me because I was giving them L's because Tyreek Hill was up in the air. Like, I didn't know what his suspension status was. I didn't know what was going on. So I didn't know where to put the Chiefs. Now, in my opinion, him being on the field just in general is a nightmare for everyone. I'm guaranteeing you that most of the other teams, like, you know, pretty much in the AFC specifically, they were like, yo, thank you, Jesus. Like, bro, even if they don't believe in Jesus, they're like, thank you, Jesus. Like, because when this man is on the field, the Chiefs are a completely different team. And, you know, defensively, you guys can say you're revamped and all that stuff like that, but everybody already knows. Just looking at the fact that you have to watch this guy all the time is very, very demanding of a defense. So I understand why the Chiefs are now being, like, you know, they're being pushed all the way back up as favorites. Now, remember, when I told you guys the record and you guys were raging on me, right? A lot of the polls were showing that it was still up in the air based on Tyreek Hill's status. It's not only me that thinks that, you know, he being on the field is a very, very huge part of what the Chiefs are. You know what I'm saying? So I'm not, going out on a limb and saying that this guy is very, very dynamic and he adds a different dimension. It's obvious what this guy brings to the table. So looking to that aspect of it, we all have to understand him being able to be out there on the field is going to make them a completely different team. So now, looking at it as far as the way the Chiefs season is going to go, they got a shot with everybody. As long as Patrick Mahomes can stay healthy, they got a shot. Like, if this guy for any reason has any kind of injury and he misses a game or whatever, like, that's an automatic L. Like, bro, directly, just put it in the file. Like, just place the L directly in the file. This all now, with the health of the other players, you know, Kelsey, other star players that are on the team, if everybody is able to do what they need to do, you know, I pretty much, the Chiefs is going right back to the AFC Championship game. Again, this is the situation that I have when you're dealing with the AFC. As long as the Patriots have Bill Belichick and Brady, I don't care if, you know, Brady is 97 years old. You still have to worry about them. Now, I know a lot of you guys are like, yo, it don't matter, bro. The Chiefs this, the Chiefs that. I understand all that. But when it comes down to it, bro, when the money's on the table, a lot of you guys that are running off at the mouth, you're not going to be running your mouth like that when you see Bill Belichick with his cutoff hoodie on your sideline like, yo, what's good? You see what I'm saying? Like, everybody is so excited, this and that, but that's the team. That's the team you just don't want to deal with. So everybody else, let me just take a look at it. Okay, the Raiders, okay. The Chargers now, that team is another dangerous team. The Jags also, because they got a new quarterback, you know what I'm saying? It might change up if they're able to play good defense. But I don't really see a lot of teams causing them any, like, major issues. Because remember this, let me just explain something to you guys. Now that we know all this information about Tyreek Hill, everybody knows now, so now all the defenses have now revamped what they were thinking, because most of us thought that he would at least get 4 to 6 games. Because they gave Zeke 6. Like, bro, like, they had text messages that the girl said that, yo, I'm setting him up, and he got 6 games. So everybody assumed that, you know, he would lose a little bit of stuff, you know, a couple games. So I'm pretty sure the first 6 games that they had to play, people thought they were going to win. Now, injury, like, as long as everything health permitting, all right? So Chiefs fan, listen to me, like, completely. I know you guys are mad at me for my last video giving you guys what I thought that their season would be, but now with this new information, you got to understand, they have a chance to win every single game. So more than likely, probably 12-4 now, bro. Like, I got to revamp everything. This is new information. You know what I'm saying? You getting this one guy back, that frees up the run game and frees up a lot of different things that that Patrick Mahomes can do under center. Because he's flying, bro. The dude is flying. Let me just, guys, if he would, like, Randy Moss was 6'4". All right, this guy's like, what, 5'10"? He's a miniature Randy Moss, because he's running right past people that are 10 to 15 yards off the line of scrimmage waiting for him to go on a streak or a post. And he's worked on his inside and outside game. So he does mean a lot to what's going to be going on. So I would say now, disregard everything else that I said before, as long as there's no new evidence that Tyreek Hill did something else crazy, he should be a determining factor in how everything works out. I do believe that now everything is different. The Chiefs are looking at the championship game if everything goes according to plan. I got to see what the Patriots do, because I do believe that Gronkowski is a huge loss. I don't know how they're going to fill that void. So more than likely, it's going to be about the defensive strategy that Bill Belichick will have. But I think that for now, I'm going Chiefs-Patriots in the championship game. I'm not overlooking everybody else's team. I'm just saying that from based on what they did last year, I think that now they've gotten a feel for it. They feel that they belong there, and it's going to be a whole different atmosphere. So that's what I'm thinking, all right? You know, you guys can tell me whatever, you know, oh, no, the Chargers, this, that, whatever, bro. We got to find out. We got to see how it plays out. But, again, I would love to hear how you guys feel about this whole situation, him being cleared versus Zeke and everything like that. Do you still believe that the guy did whatever? You know, leave it in the comments. Let me know what you're feeling. But ultimately, this is a win for the Chiefs organization. So, you know, football will be here soon. Let me know your thoughts and opinions. I'm going to see you guys and girls next time. One love.